The rumba of Scugnizzi, you know?
No. It's a song?
Yeah.
Can you sing a little bit? Can you sing?
Okay, bye.
I know live.
No, bye.
Italian Wine Podcast. Cin cin with Italian wine people.
Welcome to another Italian Wine Podcast episode of On the Road Edition, hosted by Stevie Kim. Follow her through Napoli, the traffic, the noise, and most importantly, the pizza. Join Stevie as she eats her way through southern Italy, desperately seeking the best pizza in Napoli. Today she is at La Masardona, taste testing the local delights and speaking with owners Vincenzo Piccirillo and his son Salvatore.
Padre e figlio. Okay. Let's start with padre. Vincenzo Piccirillo, also known as Enzo. Okay. Enzo, dove siamo? Raccontaci dove siamo.
Allora, noi siamo in via Giulio Cesare Capaccio, 27. Siamo a 200 metri dalla stazione e siamo a 200 metri da Piazza Mercato.
Dove, che direzione è stazione?
Stazione è qui a nord. E Piazza Mercato è qui a ovest, Piazza Mercato dove fu decapitato Masaniello, quindi insomma il nostro liberatore. E siamo quindi questa è zona mercato ed è un quartiere popolare di Napoli e la pizza fritta nasce come cibo popolare, cibo di strada, dove qui ha iniziato mia nonna nel 45, agli anni 50 insomma.
Mi dicevi.
Allora, quello che vediamo casa. Di fronte.
Can you show me the house right in front?
Là di fronte è dove nasce la pizzeria Masardona.
Ah, ok.
Dove mia nonna, negli anni, come dicevo prima, 1945, per portare un po' di economia in casa, come tante altre donne dell'epoca, si inventarono sta sorta di pizzeria. Casalinga e facevano le pizze fritte in casa. Ovviamente non è che facevano quantitativi industriali come adesso, però facevano.
Che periodo?
Mia nonna ha iniziato nel 45,
okay.
1900, dopo la seconda guerra mondiale, come diceva lui, per portare un po' di economia in casa. Si inventarono sto lavoro che facendo un po' di pizze facevano un po' di soldi da. Per poter spendere in famiglia, ecco.
Ma però come veniva questa commercializzazione?
La commercializzazione veniva che loro praticamente fuori al marciapiede di strada,
come qui.
Qua, cacciavano la tavola di casa con un bruciatore alimentato a carboni, cioè avevano sto padellone dove friggevano le pizze fritte, e quindi insomma le persone che passavano si compravano ognuno la propria pizza, ecco.
E si faceva un solo giorno alla settimana.
Okay, can you say that in English?
Yeah, sure.
Your dad was talking about how your grandmother started the whole fried pizza business.
The real first Masardona.
She's the real entrepreneur.
Yeah, the first Masardona. Was Anna Manfredi, my great grandmother, and his grandmother. She started to cook the fried pizza in the first part of the Second World War. And she worked only one day in the week.
Why is that? I don't understand. Only one day of the
only
week?
Only one day, yeah, wow. Only one day. Because in the district, one day is for one woman. A Monday work my great grandmother. Another day work another woman of another family. Is a different way to work.
So it was a community trip.
Yeah. It's a way to work in community. Okay, but the pizza of Anna. Is very good, and the people come from different part of city and ask and tell about the pizza of Masardona. And in second time my grandfather start to cook pizza every day my father start with a service and table, and after me and my brother open another location, one near the Lungomare, the sea of Naples, and my brother now work in Rome with another location.
But it's always pizza fritta.
Yeah, sure.
So you're doing the same thing you're doing here in Rome and in...
In Rome we cook also the classic pizza torn, okay? But in Naples we cook only fried pizza. If you come to our location, you can eat only fried pizza.
Okay. So your brother, how old is he? Is he older, your brother?
I am 33.
Jesus Christ. Like Jesus Christ.
I don't have answer.
L'età di Gesù Cristo.
Ah, yeah, Jesus Christ. Okay. Yeah, my brother 31.
Okay, so he's younger.
Yeah.
And you're both doing you're continuing the family business.
Yeah, sure.
So there are just two of you. There are just two of you.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
and your brother.
Me, my brother, and the little dog. It's another brother.
Okay.
Romeo.
Yeah. In really, the first Masardona, Anna Manfredi, cook only one type of pizza, the classic, with only cheese, soft cheese, ricotta. Smoked cheese, provola, ciccoli, it's a classic type of meat of pork that is defatted and floured. It's a very, very soul of fried pizza. The fresh tomato. This is a classic pizza, the completa is the name. Now we cook a different type of pizza with vegetable, with pepper, with rocket salad, because we have different type of guests.
So why do you have, what are the different types of guests you have now?
Our pizza.
When did you start working in the family business? When?
Me?
Yeah.
8 years ago. My brother the same, my father, I think he started to work for Masardona when he have 5 anni.
Yeah, 5 years old. But you know, anything fried, everything fried is good. You know, everything is so delicious, right?
It's the way to cook the fried food is important. No whole fried food is good, but if all food is fried in a good way, it's good.
So let me ask you a question. You know how women, especially women, are obsessed about dieting? So do you feel like your business has changed?
La nostra pizza vince la dieta.
No, because yes, the women won't be a beauty, no fat, okay? But our fried pizza is healthy. No healthy, it's for diet, okay? But we cook with all stuffing, very, very delicious, but no low cost, okay? We research the stuffing healthy, the stuffing of this land. This is no low cost food. It's a very quality food, no fat.
So how did the fried pizza fritta, is it from Naples originally?
Yeah, sure.
I don't know.
Yeah, it's from...
Who did the first pizza fritta?
The pizza fritta is I think one of most important is the sister of a classic pizza, start and burn in Naples. One song, the Rumba of Scugnizzi, you know? No. This is the rumba of Spignizzi. Questa è la rumba di Spignizzi.
It's a song?
Speak.
Can you sing a little bit? Can you sing?
La rumba di Spignizzi.
Ah.
Okay, vai.
No, vai.
Questa è la rumba di Spignizzi. Casa balla tutte pizze. Speak this? About a market, a popular market. And sing
mercato,
capitone, different type of food.
Yeah.
Capitone is a fish, codfish. And speak about the battilocchio. The battilocchio is the fried pizza, the little pizza.
Yeah,
it's a classic street food. This is a sign to a very, very old food. It's a just present in 1850. Yeah, it's just present in the city.
But it is definitely street food, right?
Yeah.
It's
a real street food, because of to cook the classic pizza, we needed a horn, okay?
Right.
To cook the fried pizza, all the oil, the fire with the oil. It's a simple.
Right. Okay. So what about during COVID? How did you guys survive COVID?
We are very popular also for our delivery, okay?
Oh.
We every day we cook the fried pizza also for our rider, for the people, for the office, and the people call in our pizzeria to send a pizza in the office at home. This is one of our power. And during the COVID period, we work very strong with delivery.
Okay.
Noi nasciamo come pizza, cioè noi diciamo il delivery è il nostro punto di forza, l'asporto. Perché noi la pizza fritta, a differenza di quella là a forno, c'è una tenuta migliore, quindi uno magari può preferire a ordinare una pizza fritta magari rispetto a quella a forno, specialmente d'inverno, perché magari la pizza fritta, come ti dicevo, mantiene meglio, mentre quella a forno tende a raffreddarsi prima, quindi d'inverno specialmente uno preferisce chiamare una pizza fritta. Periodo COVID, insomma, era un prodotto che andava comunque.
Okay. All right, so andiamo a mangiare questa pizza fritta.
Okay. Andiamo dentro, dai.
Okay.
And that's a wrap for this episode of How to Pizza, Naples Edition, with Stevie Kim. Join us again next time as she explores another great pizzeria, desperately seeking the best pizza in Napoli. And remember, if you want to see more great videos like these, go ahead and subscribe and hit that bell to be notified of more content when it comes out. We have even more content on our podcast. Just go to www.italianwinepodcast.com. Until next time, cin cin.